Hello, hello, and today I just wanted to make a quick comparison video here with the Ewok Battle Wagon, released in 1985 by Kenner, and also the Kenner Robin Hood Battle Wagon, released in 1991. And I just wanted to point out some of the differences here. And obviously, there is a skull on top here. I don't think it's a bantha, because it has tusks, kind of like maybe an elephant or something, but I don't know what animal that's supposed to be. The tusks are actually a softer material. Maybe it's rubber, I'm not sure. So if you don't own one, you might not know that the tusks are soft. And you actually screw them in rather than pop them in. And let's take a look at the catapult on top here. It's the Ewok catapult, basically, the same mold. And my strings are a little bit messed up here, maybe not tied on correctly. And the other obvious difference is the prisoner cage here in the back. As you can see, I'll turn it around. And with the Robin Hood Battle Wagon, there was no prisoner cage. There is, however, a little hole here, I believe for no reason whatsoever. They do have a drum, as you can see, like the Ewok Battle Wagon drum right here. And here's the hole where the string goes through, but there's also a crank back here to raise and lower the prisoner cage. Let's see, other differences. Obviously the color scheme throughout. And let's take a look at the wheels. So they added these, almost looks like, you know, metal bolts or something here. And maybe these are supposed to be metal shields, I'm not sure. Same sort of bolt concept here, and possibly metal on the front. And this is also a rubber material. And you can see the front of the Ewok Battle Wagon with those wheels here. And what else do we have? Well, those shields here are removable, which is kind of fun. The action figures can hold the shields with your Robin Hood figures. Or I guess with the Ewoks too, if you want to put Ewoks in all your Battle Wagons. I find it a little strange that they have this drum. So the Sherwood Forest playset does not come with a drum, but the Battle Wagon does. For Robin Hood, and it's maybe knee high here. I'm not even sure, because they are 4-inch figures. And I also wanted to point out, some of the fun is owning the box here, especially with the Ewok Battle Wagon. It has artwork and photography. It's a lot of fun to look at and relive throughout the years. The manual is also pretty cool, to read the instruction manual for assembly. And I don't have those, but you can always look those up on the internet. Click on images. Plenty of people have posted those. And you can always buy them on eBay, too. People sell the manuals and the boxes. But these are getting kind of pricey. Complete with the box, especially sealed, can run you $1,000 or more for this Battle Wagon. And luckily, the Robin Hood Prince of Thieves Battle Wagon is not that expensive. And often I still see sealed Battle Wagons, Prince of Thieves, under $100. Sometimes they're opened but complete, and way, way, way under $100. You might get really lucky and get one for, you know, 30 bucks plus shipping, or I've seen deals like that even in 2020. Let's check it out. I also have a video, I'll put the link in the description, featuring the Sherwood Forest playset and the Ewok Village playset as a comparison. And I'm also going to put modern figures in the Sherwood Forest and Ewok Village. The last video has all vintage, and this one also has all vintage. No modern figures here. This is all Kenner. And the Ewoks hanging out in both Battle Wagons. This channel is actually not a toy channel, but once in a while I like to feature a few Star Wars or G.I. Joe toys that I own. and thank you for watching.